That's Osama bin Laden swimming, and Jaws is about to consume him, the penis bone from a walrus. That is my painting.
Wow. I would say it's a humpback whale.
Once people know that you're involved in whales, they tend to give you whale things.
Yeah.
Someday I would love to be able to do a searchlight with the Gotham whale sign into the sky. Yes, I am Whale Man.
Paul C. Suerda, or Whale Man, is the founder of Gotham Whale, a nonprofit dedicated to studying the surprising resurgence of whales in New York City's harbor. While that resurgence is recent, Paul's fascination with whales began long ago.
The year was 1969. I was literally struck by Jacques Cousteau saying, I got to get involved in the oceans. It was an era of exploration, both astronauts and the aquanauts. So there was a lot of buzz about exploration, and I wanted to be part of that. We're advocating for the whales that are coming back to New York City. It's just a phenomenal, brand new occurrence for these whales to come to this area. So they need to be protected.
Whales used to thrive in the waters outside of New York City. In the 1700s, they were featured prominently in maps and drawings. But since then, the original humpback whale population was reduced by 95% due to hunting and pollution.
So these whales are returning because they are now protected in our waters. They're also returning because our waters right now are cleaner than they've been in decades.
That first year, we had 3 sightings with a total of 5 whales. That was for the entire summer season. But the numbers are like 270 sightings and 290 whales last year. And that number is going to be much bigger this year.
Tail slapping humpback whale, 12 o'clock.
At the heart of Gotham Whale's education and conservation efforts is a massive data collection effort made possible by partnering with citizen scientists.
There aren't enough scientists out there to be at all places at once. So that's why citizen science work is a very important contribution. And a lot of scientists are starting to recognize the benefit of citizen science organizations like us.
That gives a snapshot that you could never organize or fund or make arrangements for scientists to go out and make that kind of data collection. So by having all those eyes out there, the amount of data is just incredible.
Gotham Whale spotters are on commercial whale watching cruises like the American Princess, but boaters and kayakers often also participate. Volunteers log details of sightings, including time, exact location, and other important information, like pictures of the whale's fluke, the underside of its tail. It has unique patterns that allow Paul and his team to identify individual whales.
Those data points are starting to show various trends. Why are they coming here year over year? Are they the same whales? How long do they stay from the beginning of the season to the end? All this information will be gathered not by one or two observations, but many, many, many observations. And we want to be part of that and generate serious publications that will be recognized by decision makers, authorities.
Data collection may not sound super exciting, but it's the foundation of understanding what's happening in our world. And in this case, what's happening in the waters surrounding New York City. That information is crucial to forming policies and practices that ensure whales can continue to bounce back and thrive in this unique habitat.
I'm retired, so I can do pretty much what I want. And this is what I want to do. We want to change the perception of people that whale watching and whales and New York go together.
Here's Paul to tell you more about how you can help Gotham Whale.
If you're interested in adopting a whale, Gotham Whale provides this print along with the history, a mapping of where we saw the whale, and a letter, of course, of thanks for helping to support Gotham Whale.